What vexes me is the stupid thing about spirituality, which is half right, half wrong. It vexes me. It really, really vexes me. What vexes me is that, people want to struggle, people want to find some meaning, and people are very sincere, and I can resonate with it all. I think most of the time they seem to be very genuine in their spirituality, and I can understand it. I can understand what they're saying. I can understand why they're saying it. But goodness me, if we can take a step back from spirituality, we might be able to see, I hope we can, that the answer to life is not to root out the narcissism from one's being. I honestly, everyone competes with me on this point, but I honestly think that is a very subtle divergent pathway that leads us way off track. I honestly do. It seems good on the surface. Let's look at the past. Let's look at things that have happened, and to the extent that things have gone wrong or things didn't actually turn out as expected, which, by the way, is different from things going wrong. But to that extent that things haven't turned out exactly as we thought, let's root the narcissism out of that situation. Let's root it out from our being. Let's root it out from the other, maybe other person's being. Let's root it from society. I honestly think this might be an interesting path to go down, and I admit I've gone down it to some extent myself. But it's just a really sad, a very ultimately incorrect, ultimately delusional path that only consolidates the delusion still further. As I said to you before, and it may be difficult for anyone to grasp, even me. I can go along blithely thinking I know something and then find out. No, not yet. That was wrong. That was incorrect. Go along blithely thinking that you know enough now. You know enough now. And that surely you must be on the right path. You are rooting out narcissism. All the problems in your life, things where you misjudge the circumstance due to your naivete, which actually was due to just being a human being, just being somebody new to this earth. It's not, this is the thing, being new to the earth, being a human being that needs to learn something. That is not narcissism. If you, for example, as I saw recently on Cora, if you project your love and your fullness and your being into another person, that is just adolescence. That is, it could be post-adolescence. It's just something nice and something naive. Now, naivete is not narcissism. This is unfortunate that you think naivete is narcissism. This is unfortunate that you think you can block the holes in your being, block something, block some kind of spiritual, some kind of, deficit. You think you can block a spiritual deficit and somehow create a path for yourself in the future that is devoid of such mistakes. You are consolidating your naivete. You are not improving on that matter. You are not. You're not consolidating it. You are actually just not understanding what youth is. Youth is the opportunity to make mistakes. And if one makes a mistake, that is not down to narcissism. It's not down to your narcissism. It's not down to somebody else's narcissism. I mean, it could be, but it's much more likely to be down to the fact that we are not endowed with full knowledge, full understanding of any situation that we may enter. Now, that is the realistic viewpoint. And it bothers me because it's the new orthodoxy, I suppose. It's the new orthodoxy to think that somehow we can perfect our beings. It's the new navel gazing, but we shouldn't think too badly on ourselves just because we navel gaze. We are, oftentimes bored, oftentimes simply alienated, alone, trying to find our way through things. Things can get very musical. Oh goodness, what have I done? What have I done? I don't know, I've selected too many. Go away! I never will get them to go away now. I am stuck. Yikes, help, stop sounds. Okay, stop sounds. It's the counterspell on voice mod, stop sounds. So learn the counterspell if you cast a spell. But honestly, this whole view that narcissism is the cause of things, you know, I've been a real fundamental victim of that because I happen to be brought up in the developing world in a situation that people would like to stigmatize. And instead of helping me out, instead of understanding what I'm telling them, instead of understanding my story, instead of listening closely enough to understand what I'm saying about my difference, that I wasn't even here in the present. I wasn't even in, you know, the developed world until 15, 16. Instead of listening to that, people assume that I must have been narcissistic, that I must have been full of myself and just not paying attention to anything, and therefore I deserve comeuppance. I mean, you know, this ideology has to go. This ideology has to go. I've been in and out of it. I know. I've paid my dues. I know what's there. I understand it more than maybe anybody does, because I've been in it deeper, into the ideology that if one doesn't know something, that must be due to narcissism. I've been into that more deeply than anybody has, I think, because I've studied it for a longer time, because it's had a personal impression on my life, and because I have been discriminated against and really received a lot of hostility because I didn't know what I couldn't know, because I hadn't been in location for the first 15 years of my life. And because people deem that the reason for that is narcissism. Why weren't you here on location? Why weren't you in the developed world from point go? Is there a missing gap from the age of 0 to 15? Because I was fucking elsewhere. I was quite literally not there, not physically present. That's why. But will people believe that? No, they won't. They reduce it to a matter of narcissism. I must have been really full of myself not to have been where I should have been, where everybody else apparently was. I must have been so self-gratified with myself not to have been in another place geographically, even though I couldn't have been. You see, it's just really... I've had the lesson. I've had the lesson of the spirituality, you know. I've had that lesson of the false path. I understand the criticism, the critique of the spiritual people, the one that they would like to make, and I call bullshit. I say, no, no. I mean, really, think about it. I've said it a little bit before. I know I have expressed my view on the matter. Oh, I'm trying to get sound back. Come back, wherever you are. Can't do. Doesn't matter. Just having some fun. But you know, the very spiritual people are not really helping. I don't want to understate that. The very spiritual people, you know, they actually need some education in a lot of different ways other than spirituality. They need to listen, and they need to take notes in a real sense, not just sitting back and pretending to take notes, but actually learning that there is something they don't know about the world, that not every situation is the same, and above all, learn that a lack of knowledge and experience in any area of life does not imply that somebody was out to lunch, doesn't imply at all that they were narcissists or that there's a narcissistic hole that needs to be plugged. I mean, this is something that people are very unawares or fundamentally stupid about. I mean, therapists too, the dear brutes, they need to learn as well. A lot of people. Let's go back to school. Let's sit at that desk with the little hole for the inkwell. Let's go back. Let's take a few steps back, just a couple, and try and learn that there is something that we don't know, and that the explanation cannot be plugged with the idea that all lack of knowledge is due to narcissism. That's something that educated people need to know. Educated people need to do in order to be knowledgeable, in order not to make this error of judgment.